Yo, what's up guys, K1 off here, and today I bring you a brand new video. Today's video is on Formula 1 2021. Got the game recently on PS5, and you've got Steam World as well. We're going to jump into a bit of my team, get this thing started, and see how we go. I'm going to make our own team. We're going to kind of see how we get on Formula 1. We've got Steam World, we've got Pedals. I played a bit more with my mates the other day, and I weren't too bad. I weren't the best. I was like shocking, but We're gonna jump into the my team and see how we get on. So let's do it. So here we go, my team. We're gonna go for a full season. Because why not? We're gonna get this going. We're gonna use the recommended settings because yeah, I'm not afraid. And it's gonna give you the best balance. I'm gonna use my team I want enabled, my team I'm gonna be displayed. We're going to use my team icon, why not? Oh, you gotta buy that. Oh, I'm not buying that, no. We'll start without that. Start a career with a selected option. After confirming the option, we are to create. Okay, let's go. My driver. We're gonna go with that avatar. We're being, of course, we're gonna be British, so that's what we are. We're gonna be anything else. Oh, for fuck's sake. You can't have that in your initials. Hasty. Obviously you can't be number one, which is pretty depressing. So we're gonna go with, can't be number nine either. No, we'll go with 19 then, make sure it's 1 and 9. Like that. Okay, let's advance. Now look at my clothing, helmet. I want this helmet, but I want to change the colour. We'll keep the white, but we're gonna change the red to blue. Okay, dark blue. Down close. I don't know what bit we're changing, so this bit kinda gonna be black as well. Do that bit. Hold on. Blue. Again, we're gonna go with this one. That is good. Blue and black looks really good actually. I'm gonna go with blue and black. And then we'll get these colors as well. Nice. We'll change the color of the red to the black again. Character pose. We're gonna go with the casual Casey stance. And volleyballs. That's all I've done all the time. Podium emotes. We'll stick with that one. Normal celebration. This video is cool. I'm gonna go with the woo. found one up. I'm going to do it. And that's a van.
Great. Now let's set up some of the key details of the new team. We'll start with an easy one. What name would you like to give the team?
And this is where we can call it.
Signing bonus to the team up front. This is vital to cover the early investments we need to make. They will also provide valuable weekly income for us. Each sponsor has a goal they want the team to achieve. If we hit that goal, the sponsor will pay us an additional goal bonus.
Okay, so obviously the higher the signing bonus, the higher the goal is, but also the kind of not all, but then also the higher the weekly income is. Who shall we go for? We've got to complete the full season with these. We've got to get in 10th or better in the Constructed Championship. Earn 15 Constructed Championship points in a season. Or other team achieve 2 points finishes during a season. Finish 8th or better with these guys. And a 5. Team 5 finishes. And 25. Bonuses there, but we're not that good, so we don't want to go for a really good one. I'm going to go for the RDB as our main one. They'll give us 4.4 mil. We get a goal bonus of 2.24 mil if we complete their challenge. And we get a weekly income of 268k, which also gives us, if we win, we've got to get 10th or better in the championship. I reckon we can do that.
Now we've got a budget to work with.
I reckon we can do that.
Anywhere fast without a power unit. So, let's sign a power unit supplier now. We need both performance and durability from our power units, but we also need to balance the books. We're going to have a lot of other areas to invest our cash into.
We need power and durability. It's either Honda or Mercedes for me. Honda has high performance and high durability. And then Mercedes. We're gonna go to Mercedes. Gonna have to be Mercedes. Sorry. So we've got. We get 4k from 4.4 mil from them. And we've lost 3 mil. So we've got a mil on a bit.
The drivers available to be your first teammate. They all have their own strengths and weaknesses. So consider everything. Drivers earn a claim based on their performances. When a driver earns enough acclaim, they will level up. The higher a driver's level, the more acclaim they will earn for their current team. Remember, the faster the team levels up, the faster our income will increase. The higher a driver's experience, the more resource points are earned to spend on vehicle upgrades. Racecraft is a driver's skill to effectively complete overtakes when opportunities arise. Awareness shows the driver's ability to avoid errors and incidents. Pace describes the driver's ability to set competitive lap times. Focus represents the driver's current form and state of mind. Rating is a summary of the driver's overall skill.
Let's see what we can get. This guy sitting in the cage, 22 experience, he's pretty much playing. 60 playing, 60 awareness and 76 pace, with an 81 focus. This guy seems fucking good. We're going for him.
We're going with system. Go ahead and confirm if you're happy.
We're going to go with Mercedes, with Tipton as our driver. He seems decent and he's also British. And we're keeping it in there.
Delivery will be running this season. We can add more sponsors to the car as we sign them throughout the year. And don't worry, we can edit our look at any time from HQ.
Alright, should we go with this? Sorry, we're going to go with this one. And we're going to change the main colour. Dark blue. not dominate with men. With the black. And also with the black. The dominant and the black, it just looks so clean. It has to be done. You can edit some shit when you finish setting out your chain. Okay, personal to good. I wonder what that wavelength is. Engineer insanity. Yeah, what we like. Sounds good to me.
Last but not least, we need to consider our brand. Badge.
Team badge. Kinda okay. Might go with one that I like. Yeah, we're gonna go for this one. And again, we're gonna change the color. Go with the blue and black. I like colors. Colors on the blue. That is what I want. And then a black. I want to see where this color is going. Oh, it's like that. You know what? The green does look good actually. So we'll go with that.
Great. That's everything we need.
We will go with that.
We can edit anything we've done so far. And we'll come back here at the start of each season. But if you're ready to go, hit advance to head to the team HQ. We can start our push at the top of Formula One.
Let's go. Let's go to the team headquarters. Let's do it. Do it. I follow on drivers receive a lot of media attention and how you deal with the press can have an impact on several aspects of your career. Interviews can occur after any season, any session of a race weekend, according to what happened and how you performed. How you answer the interview question can affect your morale or your R&D department, your teammate motivation and your claim. Consider your answers carefully. You should need to answer can frustrate the press, leading them to ask you tougher questions in the future. In my opinion, your answers can even influence the direction the team takes for you is a track. Some answers in your preseason interview will advance your R&D in pursuit areas, to choose wisely. The media coach perk can be purchased through the contract between the team HQ, but no answers can make it out of difficult situations or give you a bigger boost to your claim to your team. There are 3 levels of this perk to unlock.
Hello folks, and welcome to this, a very special edition of Paddock Pass. As you can see, there's no pit lane behind me, and as you can hear, no roar of engines, and that's because they've set me free from the F1 paddock to escape here to the countryside and to the headquarters of Formula One's newest team. Now, it's not every day we get to pull back the curtain and look behind the scenes at an F1 team. Rarer still, we get to talk not only to the team owner, but also the team's lead driver. But what makes this place extra special is that the owner and lead driver are one and the same person. Now, it's been an interesting 12 months, and we all know a number of the regulation changes which were due to come into effect this year have been delayed until next. Some, though, are still seeing the light of day, amongst them the all-important budget cap, which gives some of the smaller teams, a little further down the order, potentially, the opportunity to compete with the bigger teams. Good for them, but great for us as viewers. But what does our new team owner think about these new rules? Do they see them as a challenge, a hurdle that needs to be overcome? Perhaps they see them as an opportunity to disrupt the status quo, a chance to come out swinging and to carve their name into Formula One history. Well, I had the opportunity to ask them these very questions just earlier today, and here's what they have to say.
Well,
first of all, thanks so much for inviting us here today. It's been wonderful to see behind the scenes. As you might expect, I've got
our clothes look sick though. Look at them colours. Straight in. Blue, black and green.
It's been a long time since we last saw a team owner take their own car onto the track, and the sport's changed enormously in the intervening years. How are you going to handle the responsibilities of both managing and driving for a Formula One team? Let's talk about your teammate. Now, it's clear they're excited to have signed with you, but tell me, what is it that you think they bring to the team? This is the reason I am leaving. I can't live with or without you. Oh, won't you sing to me? There ain't no other way. So you've obviously been putting a lot of work into the car. I know it's early days, but how do you expect it to feel out there? Most of the other teams can boast years of experience in Formula One. Where do you see the opportunities to make those vital performance gains you need to put you within reach of the other cars? Ultimately, the success this season is going to come down to whether you can take positions from the other drivers. What is it about your car that's going to give you that edge in those battles? And finally, with so many specialist departments working together here at your headquarters, and with such an important deadline coming up, who's getting that coveted teacher's gold star? Which group do you feel the most proud of right now?
I want more durability and power. More durability for me, better.
Thank you for today. Really,
I'm a shit driver, though. We need to get a good durable car that can last us and not crash. Okay, I'm one of the first. Your team bad angels want to give you guys 8 weeks, and bring when you complete their objectives. Is the result point you use them to help your team upgrade the car? Income in the R&D. In the claim, as this increases third of your income from sponsors, many of our top drivers won't consider moving to a lower claim team to get out of their reviews on the track before approaching them. Okay.
This is where you can view our current facilities and the effects they are having on the business. You can also invest some of our cash into upgrades for these facilities.
It's important for one team to continue to develop the Garbrandt season, even if we can offer free practice sessions. You only even perform practice programs, which will earn you resource points that can be spent on upgrades for your car. Playing specific objectives in the program will earn you development boosts, reducing the cost of some upgrades. You should pursue upgrades in each of the four R&D departments. Playing upgrades reveal more avenues of development for you to consider making more complicated and more expensive upgrades. Able to research from time to time, you'll also receive upgrade from your engine supplier. As your facilities get upgraded, you'll be able to develop multiple upgrades at once, speed up the degree of upgrade, and have fewer failed upgrades. Consider carefully how to manage morale in your R&D department, keeping in mind the effect of what you say and do. Good or bad morale can have an effect on both the time it takes to develop an upgrade and the likelihood of facing failure. Okay, so already you can see that our powertrain is already up for like poor morale and third our durability. We kind of need to get our aerodynamic and chassis up. So let's have a look at our aerodynamics and see what we can upgrade. The 4% chance of failure. We don't want to do that yet. I tell you what, we're not going to do anything in our car yet. We're just going to go and get into our activities.
It's important to use the time between races to the fullest extent. That's where the activities come in. Manage everyone's time as efficiently as possible to maximize the team's performance.
We do pre-season merchandise there. We'll get 5 and 8 in. That will then get kind of the morale going in the team, and we can go from there. So we will do that. Right, when you work in your mailbox, yep, very green. New car smell. To all team members, the IT department, thank you for the patience during the recent downtime. It confirmed the issue with our internal network has been resolved. Should all have full access to the system required by your role. If you got any further issues, come back then for citizenship raids. Okay, I'm going to return to overview and we are going to advance. Stop there. We'll look where we're at. This is our car reveal. Original Challenge campaign. I want to do that because the morale of the other two going down, but they're already up anyway. So we are going to do that actually. Go to the car reveal. Let's go to our car reveal. It does look fucking good though. I like the blue and the blue and black. That looks clean, man. Tell me that don't look clean, guys. Let me know what you think of that. It looks so nice, man. Looks so nice. Alright, let's advance. Alright, we're going to go to the tire allocation first. Okay, that's fine. Gearbox. our unit on it. Let's go to the race weekend, guys. First races of the season. Let's do it. And it's one of the hardest maps as well. One of the hardest areas to do, Bahrain. But it's gonna be good. We're gonna get this done.
I'm Andrea. I'm head of R&D for the team. So get used to hearing a lot from me over the season. If I get too annoying, be sure to let me, okay? This is your seat. So get settled in. Welcome to the team.
Oh, let's go to the workstation. We've got our practices. We can do three practices. We've got one short qualifying, and then we have the race. The race is R5. We're gonna. We're only gonna do. We're gonna go for the medium, so it's 14 laps, actually. We'll go to that one first. We'll do 14 laps. Tutorial available, don't need any tutorial. We're in four cars, should be good to go. We're fitting a number of new developments to the car. Try them out and know how they feel. Cool, week preview, attack preview. Okay, we've got Mercedes Hamilton in first. With Red Bull in second, with Verstappen in third. We are number 22. Tutorial available, I'm in fourth. Yeah, cool. Right, go back to the workstation. We're going to go to practice one. Let's give the first practice a go. The Gulf Air Bahrain Grand Prix.
Boss, Jeff here. Thanks again for bringing me on board. You've found a lot of talented people for this team. I can't wait to see what we can accomplish.
There you go, we've got
our
Jeff.
Our journey to the Constructors' Championship starts here today, and the car is ready to head out whenever you are.
Schedule, pre-run decisions of what part of the country we can. Not only do they give you the opportunity to learn the track, they also rain. What's back in the program which can be completed to find the rental of your car. Pre-run program will earn you resource point where you can spend on upgrades. Each program offers a number of development boosts. Completing one of these give your R&D team valuable insight into your car performance, resulting in cheaper upgrades. You may adjust your car setup over the course of these sessions to try and find those extra fractions of a second. Note that the sporting regulations dictate that after each free practice session, you must hand back two sets of your dry tire allocation for the weekend, so get the most out of them while you can. Okay, session info. Our race strategy. Gonna go medium, 5 lap, which is recommended. 5 set, that's only 28. You know what? Let's just go for it. I'm not going to change anything, because I'm sure you're going to get we're just going to drive out.
A few laps under our belt.
Let's do a drive out. Okay, it does it itself. I've done a few trial runs on Bahrain, so I kind of know what it's like.
Thank you.
I'm telling you that, honestly. Not bad. I'm getting used to it. I'm getting used to it. I don't know who that are. Bahrain has some very, very tight corners. Alright, our rates are pretty decent, which is good. We're getting there, boy. We're a second ahead and then off. I think I might have braking assist, but you know, I think I've got steering or braking assist on. Something, don't know what. Definitely not braking assist.
Okay, just want to remind you to keep an eye on your tyre temperatures, which you can do on the temperature panel of the MFD. We monitor carcass temperature and surface temperature, and you'll get the best performance when they're both inside a normal operating window. Surface temps tend to fluctuate faster, so try a few laps with the data open and get a feel for how to...
That corner, I need to remember to slow down going on that corner. It pulled me quite a bit actually. Got a purple S1, which is good. purple SG as well. We're doing it.
Well done.
I put a fast lap. Let's return to the garage. I've done a good enough job there.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Blue, Leclerc, and Carlos Sainz. What an incredible practice session. The fun doesn't stop here, though. Join us again as the rest of the weekend unfolds.
There you go. We were top. Practice one, round one. We were top of the leaderboard. Coming in first. I'm not doing that yet. What is this one? Our practice 2. We're going into practice 3 and then we'll go into the race. We'll go to quick practice again because I really can't be bothered. And that session, the past two things, we're all good. Right, let's get into qualifying. Practice program pass for total 200,000 and 260. Development boosted applied. Ignition system. Rear wing maintain. And some more ignition system. What we like. 2%, he's on 4-1, he's on 4, he's on 8%, I'm on 2%. Wind is 10% acclaim. Let's go. We're on 10% acclaim. We're gonna go into this one shot qualifying. Hopefully we can get quite high up and get into a good position. Okay, fairly straightforward layout. First of all, turn 10. I'll hit left hander, you'll be tail breaking and down shifting all the way to the apex. You start to look up, he's off the brake, you can't afford to be much here. Taking me the final corner, it's a long straight, long start and finish straight. You really want to carry much speed as possible. A track widening at the exit, so you can probably take an early apex. Cheers, Jeff. Appreciate your help on that one, mate. Absolute legend. Let's go to qualifying. Let's do this, qualifying, one shot qualifying. Let's do it. Yeah, that way we're gonna stick with our soft tires. Just because I think that's gonna be our best option. And let's do it. Ah, nearly fucking lost it there. Come on, we're in position one. We're getting there. We're doing it. Take these corners quite far. Down for that, get on the straight. Still in position one. Still in position one. Are we gonna start in pole? Are we getting pole?
Excellent lap. We're really pleased.
That was a great first lap. Clean as well. So clean. Very clean first lap.
And with qualifying complete,
that put me in pole.
Review our top three today.
That has got me in pole.
And Lewis Hamilton.
How the fuck have I got pole?
Really just getting started. Make sure to join us again.
How the fuck did I get pole on that
amazing
first race?
Performance out there. I'm sure you're
what
pretty happy
fuck?
With that. Looks like you had a great qualifying session. It must be a relief being that far up the grid. It looks like you've really been focusing on research and development this season. Appreciate your time.
That put me up quite a bit there. We boosted our plane with two now. That was fucking madness. How the hell have I got pole position in the first race?
All right, I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
What have I done to get fucking pole? Okay, good luck. You know the drill, get in turn one. Take the chances you get, but I don't want you to see drag. You're dragging a busted front wing into the pit, and remember to make good use of the overtake button. You've got a full battery at the start of the race. You may as well make the most of it. Cheers, Jeff. Let's go. 14 laps. Let's get it. Here we go. Are we ready?
Months of rumour and speculation all come to an end today as we return to racing for the opening events of what promises to be an enthralling season. Welcome along then to round one of this year's Formula One World Championship. There's no shortage of passing opportunities around the 3.36 miles of the Bahrain International Circuit, with the best at turn one, of course, and then another soon into turn four. 15 corners here, 6 to the left and 9 to the right, and we could see one or two flat spots into the tight left-hander of turn 10.
Oh, it's going to be a good race.
A new season then, a clean slate where anything could happen. Anthony Davidson is with me today as we get another year of Formula One underway.
We're into those tense few minutes before the first race then. Everyone's a little bit nervous about reliability. They haven't been running in the hot, turbulent wake of other cars in practice. They've not been pushing at 100% for long durations. Let's hope no one has to deal with any nasty surprises.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Blue lines up on pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Perez, Valtteri Bottas, and Leclerc, Norris, Ricciardo, Sainz, and Sebastian Vettel, Gasly, Fernando Alonso, Lance Stroll, and Tsunoda, Russell, Ocon, Kimi Raikkonen, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Tictum, Mick Schumacher, Latifi.
Go on,
Tictum,
you gotta get out there, bro. You gotta get out in the top 10.
Just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
You're gonna get into the top 10 for me, Tictum. I bet you're really bad.
We're going to need you to push hard if we're going to get a good result today. Let's make it happen.
Right there, that light as well. That was a good boy. On, turn. Oh, I'm not got the control that I did when I was doing the warm up. What's going on? Doesn't seem to have the same control. Second, doing well. Stephen, man, he needed to be there, wasn't he? This is going to be a meme with Stephen, right, isn't it? Got a purple 6-1. Nah, fucked it. Come on. We're doing bits. Got purple F1 and F2. We're doing it.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums.
We're leading our teammate by 21.9 seconds.
Oh, why was it a yellow flag? What the fuck?
Green flag, check your MFD for a new strategy option. Some information on Norris. They are out of the race.
Oh, what? Nando's out of the race? No. Love Lando. I think I got braking assist on. I don't think we're going to break our record. controller. Haven't gone into the pit. I'm running away with this. Then we can knock one or two more laps on these wheels, and then we'll have to go into the pit. By that time, we'll have a much bigger lead, and we'll be able to get away with it.
Tire condition is still looking good.
Yeah, decent. We had to tell it as well. I know what I'm talking about, boys. Let's do this. Going 7 seconds here.
We want to pit this lap, so push now. Daniel is coming in for his stop.
I've got a 21 second lead. What is this? How am I doing so well? My first race properly on the game, like career mode. I had to get my friend and I was terrible. Like, what is this? How am I doing so well? I didn't need to slow down, I wanted to. Alright, get into the pit. We've got a good 20 second lead.
Complete, go now.
Not a bad pit, you know. 2.7 seconds top time.
Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track.
There you go, only got down to what, 8? Only got down to an 8 second lead from 20 seconds. Not bad. We're absolutely smashing this race. Let's go.
is 42.0 seconds.
Fucking hell, mate. My teammate, I've obliterated. Fuck that way there. So let's go, we're still 10 seconds in the lead. Four more laps to go. We've got a 10 second lead. Let's do this. Please don't tell me that I slowed down and went wrong recording. Some of my second camera just fucked up. Oh well, we're still going. Four laps to go. Oh yeah, I've still got past this lap. Still got past this extra one. So we are all good. Go, baby. Again, three laps to go. Three laps to go with a 10 second lead, nearly 11 second lead. We got this.
You've lost some time to the car behind.
Ah, for now, fuck. Got verbal 31 again though. Yeah,
there's 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Good, I only need 2. Yes, fire this up. Go down, boy. 0.4 for the second. good, it's good, it's good. Put your foot to the floor and go. We're nearly at our last lap. We're nearly at the last lap.
This is your final lap. Final lap of the race.
I've got a 15 second lead on this right now, this race. I could literally just drive around at like 20 miles an hour and still win. Cool.
Laps of fuel remaining.
Good job on the last lap then, innit? Let's go, boys! First race, first dub, pole position, and we win the race. Let's go. That's what we like to see.
That's it for another spectacular Grand Prix here in Bahrain, and a real champion's drive to take the win. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
I think that smart time management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.
What we like, boys. We've done that, we've smashed it.
Let's have a quick look at how the driver standings have changed. Blue takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Kimi Raikkonen is my standout today. Nothing you could construe as showboating, just...
Now that is what we like to see. Well played.
So that was an exciting race from our perspective. Let's have yours. You took the top points today. Was it a comfortable win? You really looked in control of your car out there. Your team must be thrilled. Great. Well, that's everything.
I'm loving the colours that I've picked. Like the blue and the green and the black. It looks so clean. And I'm going to go to 4%. Tim, you need to do better, mate. Opportunity in the sponsorship. Sure. Right, we're going back to help horse. Right, we're going to end this third video here. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you have, smash that like button. Subscribe if you're new. and we'll be back in the next one. I know this has been a long video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I've enjoyed making it. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.